session. Hello and welcome back to Retro Mellow Eurovision Classic.
Hello.
How are you?
Very fine, Lennart, and I'm happy today. You know why?
No, tell me.
Because I have chosen one song to us.
Oh,
yeah.
Exciting. Which one is it?
It's from 1979, Portugal with the singer Manuela Bravo.
Oh.
And she sings Sobe, Sobe, Balao, Sobe.
Oh. This song is so good.
Yeah, I like it.
I like it, and I like her performance. She's very, she's a very good singer.
Yes, it is. Yeah. She is.
Yeah. And she does a good performance. I think this was one of my favorites in 1979.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what I thought about it when we did 1979, but yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
Winning in 1979 was... Marie Myriane.
No, Hallelujah.
No, Hallelujah. No, sorry.
Milk and Honey.
Milk and Honey. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Mashiach. Hallelujah. Al Yom Shemeir. Not one of my favorite songs, but,
yeah,
you know, it's very loved and liked by a lot of people.
Yeah.
So, who was Manuela Bravo?
She was a Portuguese singer, and she won the festival, the Cancão, in 79.
Yes.
And they have, you know, three semi-finals. They had.
Already back in 79, they did the semi-finals.
They had.
I did not know that.
Long before Sweden got
Long won. Before Sweden, and long before many other countries.
Yeah.
Yes. So she won, but in second place, this song came.
Yeah.
So coming second in the Portuguese national final was Gabriela Schaaf.
Yeah.
That sounds German, don't it?
Yes, it does.
I don't know. Yeah. Singing Eu Só Quero.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm. So which song do you prefer, Harry?
I prefer the winner. Because
yes, I do too.
Yeah.
But I that doesn't mean I don't like this one. They're very different.
They're different.
This
is
sort of jazzy, sort of
blues,
a little
maybe.
Laid back, cool. And the winning song by Manuela is more... party.
Up to beat.
Upbeat.
Upbeat, yeah.
O meu amor comigo, pois eu sei que encontrei o lugar ideal para amar. Yes, it is. And it's a very good song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, the result of Portugal 1979 and Manuela Bravo was ninth place.
Yes.
Mm.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think maybe a little bit better was deserved, but there were a lot of good songs in 1979.
Yeah, it is. It was.
I think it was the year of Genghis Khan.
Yes.
Yes. And who could forget that?
Nobody.
Yes, but she did good, and I think this is a bit of a forgotten gem.
Yeah, it is.
That's why it's fun to talk about it.
Yeah.
Because a lot of the times those. Songs that aren't necessarily remembered right away, it's fun to look deeper into them.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
And I think Portugal has the same difficulties as Finland has.
They do.
Because the language.
It did take them a lot of years to win.
Yes, it is. It did.
But when they did, they sung in Portuguese.
Yeah.
Which is a good pride.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm.
Sozinho, talvez devagarinho possas voltar a aprender.
And this whole thing about languages in Eurovision, right now the trend seems to be that countries are favored if they
singing in their national language. That was not the case.
No, that was not the case. But after Brexit, it happened.
Yeah, maybe it was Brexit. But, you know, in the 80s, a lot of people complained about not being able to sing in English because they thought that songs in English were usually more successful, which was true for that time.
Yeah.
So, but everything comes back. Yeah. It's all full circle.
And, you know, UK, United Kingdom has became lost with 0 points several times now.
Yes, they have.
Yeah.
And they were so successful back in the 80s and
90s. Yeah, yeah, they were.
We're getting off track. But this was Manuela Bravo singing Soye Bala Soye.
Sobe, sobe Bala Sobe.
Sobe Bala Sobe.
Yeah.
Yes.
Very nice title. I don't know what it means.
No, but a very good song.
Yeah.
And thank you for this choice, Harry.
Yeah, thank you.
And thank you for listening. And we'll see you all again soon.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.